Hello everyone, welcome back to Arx Fatalis. So my current mission, at least what I'm supposed to do to progress the main story, is go to the Temple of Akaba, which is under the tavern, that I now have the secret word to. So that's what I need to do, but that's not actually what I want to do at the moment. So another thing that I also can do is try to find Shawnee, who is on the... what floor was it? Four? Yeah, floor number four. Or level number four. Although I couldn't find a way to actually get to her when I was on that level. So that's just right up here. So those are the kind of quests that I can do, but I just got here to the fifth level. And I think I just want to explore around here. And particularly, I want to level up because I'm actually very, very close. I need 298 more XP, which is barely anything. And then once I level up, I can get my close combat to 40, which will allow me to use this weapon, which is way, way better than the axe that I have. Yeah, way better. And then I can also upgrade my technical skill, which should allow me to lockpick things easier. So, yeah, I'm just gonna explore around. Also, I received a bunch of very helpful tips. One of which is that I need to actually hold down my charge for my weapons longer. So you do more damage the longer you charge up your weapon, up to a point. And I figured if you just held it down for like a second, you'd be fine. But what I didn't realize is that the gem at the center bottom of the screen actually lights up as the charge reaches its full potential. Which, if you look at it, actually takes more like a second and a half to maybe even 2 seconds. Yeah, so I need to hold down my swings a little bit longer. Apparently it makes a big difference to damage. Oh yeah, I should probably queue up some magic missiles. Okay, eardrums are going to explode in 3, 2, 1. Okay, maybe a little bit longer than that. Piles of bones. Such low fidelity bones that they barely look like bones. But nonetheless, I can tell just barely that they're bones. Bones. What the hell is this used for? Looks like it transports something. Even deeper underground. Perhaps it transports bones? I hear a troll. It's big and hairy and it needs to be banned immediately, so I can't leave any comments. My eardrums. Oh, come on! Why do I keep failing it? There we go. Damn it. What am I doing wrong? Alright, I think it needs to be less of a V like this. Yeah, less of a V and more like that. Anyway. Oh god, I'm in a corner. Ow. Oh shit. You know, I was gonna use melee just because it's more fun, but I've actually taken quite a bit of damage now, so... Back to magic. Damn it, I did it again! Man, it's almost overpowered. I mean, if you have enough patience, you could just continue to do that for the entire fight and just kite him around. I could eat some food to get my health back, but there's no need to. Unless I'm about to enter another fight. Keep doing that. And that doesn't work either. I seem to have suddenly lost the ability to make this damn symbol. I just need to go straight down. There we go. Okay. Always be vigilant for secrets. There are many. Secret switches, levers, thingamabobs, duomadads. It's a suspicious block of blurriness. I think this may be the shameful work of some level designer, though. Not a source of treasure. I can tell because the moss is growing on this side of the pillar that there is treasure in this direction. Oh crap, it led me to a wall. Damn you, moss! I believed in you. Oh no. I think I forgot the torch thing again. How do you light stuff? Yeah, I forgot. Damn it. Did I seriously just forget it again? Why is that not working? What the hell? Is this a special torch or something? Like, why isn't it lighting? Hold on, let me just confirm that this actually works. Actually, I don't have any backup torches. Yeah, I'm actually almost burnt through all my torches. Anyway, if I'm doing this correctly, then this should work. Yeah. Damn torch is defective.
Let's go. Now, leap first.
What are we talking about? Let's listen. Keep talking. They're not gonna keep talking. Hi, I come in peace.
What are you doing here?
We Earth people live here cause it's good. We is hate water people.
Racist.
Why?
Because them smell like fish. Them stupid. If you is kill all of them, we pay you with gold. We has got secret treasure.
I'll consider it.
Amshigar is such an apathetic hero. I use that with air quotes. Hero. It's like, I'll do it if I feel like it. Ew, they're eating rats. Uncooked rats, by the look of it. Here, you know, I'm gonna give you guys a gift. Okay? You're welcome. Alright, so they want me to kill the water people. can do, if they're violent. I don't want to kill people that, you know, are friendly. A chunk of gold! Oh, I don't even need to use a pickaxe? Can I put it down? Can I just take it? Wait. A pickaxe doesn't work for getting gold. Oh no, I was using it wrong. Whoops. Yeah. Freaking chunk of gold. I love this place. I love this place. I love this place. Yes, more gold. I am going to be the richest apathetic hero in all of the realms. What the fuck? I don't understand. What is up with these torches? Okay, that one works. This goes down, right? Kinda. Not really. What? I just got hurt somehow. Okay, that's the noise I heard before, the creepy-ass noise. Also, I think it's just kind of invisible. I think that was a ratman. And now I'm poisoned. I should probably save it. There we go. Where'd you go? Where did you go? Invisible. Invisible little prick. I just heard it again. That, or I heard the goblins drinking or something. Little ninja fuckers. Let's see what's this way. Oh my. I think I'm just gonna sit back and see what happens. Okay, that sounded like a ratman again. Hi, goblins. Okay, at least the goblins are my friend.
Lords, attack!
Hey! Human!
Hey.
Oh, never
Human.
Mind. Never mind.
Where you go? Damn you! Help!
Was that the you've leveled up sound? Yes, it was. Okay, hold on. Sweet, 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 sweet. Bless you. I mean, I'm not here. Torch. Excellent. Wine? I don't really need it, but whatever. Who cares? I've got so much inventory space now. Okay, so... Well, first thing I'm gonna do is spend it in... See, if I get up to 14 strength, I can wear that super heavy armor. But, I kind of want to just put it in mental.
Me hungry.
Yeah, let's put it in mental. Okay, now I'm going to get my close combat up to 40 so I can use this weapon. Let's get technical up to 50, and then after that, I don't know. Okay, where else should I spend it? Object knowledge is good. You know, defense is good, casting's good. I love the idle sounds that the goblins and trolls make. It's like, nom nom, nom nom nom. Casting? Let's go with casting. Alright, sweet. Now I can use this bejeweled longsword of extra damage.
We soon have promotion. Soon, me important. Top goblin. Ha ha.
37 out of 80 durability, which actually isn't great, but whatever. Yeah, so my attack goes from... Wait, what? It goes from 19 to 20? That's a joke, right? Oh no, this is my armor class. What the fuck am I smoking? It goes from 10 to 13. Okay, that makes more sense. I was looking at my armor class. Yeah, it goes up because it has a plus 1 AC. Thanks to its bejeweledness, I guess. Right, was there something else that I was going to wear when I got to 40, or was that something I was looking at? I think I was looking at a sword that I could buy that required 40 close combat. Yeah, I don't believe there's anything to equip. So yeah, look at that sword. Oh man, it looks really long. I wonder if I can attack from a further distance now. One stabbing motion. There we go. I'm gonna stab him right in the head.
Oi, you!
Damn! This sword is amazing! Yeah, I don't really need a rope, but I have so much inventory space, I might as well just take it. That mushroom can stay there. Mushrooms are worth jack shit. That's a suspicious wall. And that's let's try that again. That's a suspicious lock. Alright, well, I did just get my my technical skill up to 50. So let's give it a shot. 50, 55, okay. Both of those are full durability.
It's impossible.
Okay, now, yeah, as someone told me, if he says it's impossible, it apparently is actually impossible. So there's no point in even trying. In fact, it doesn't even use up the durability of the tools. Now, I can't remember if that means it's impossible at my current skill level, or if that means literally you need a key. Or something like that to open it. You just can never lockpick it. I'm not sure. You know, I really need to hard save it more. I have a severe lack of hard saves. Oh, hello, okay. Here's a portal we can activate. It's a mega specium. Alright. So, let's look up mega specium. Specium? Mega.
Mega.
Okay.
Mega.
Wrong key.
Mega.
There we go. Let's go ahead and make a hard save. Save 7. Okay, gate leading to the city of Arx, level 1. Let's just... Oh, there's even a little image there. Aw, that's cute. Let's just use it just for the hell of it. Just to see it in action. Alright, sweet. Hey, doggy! Wanna come with me to another realm? You follow me, right? You gonna follow me? Yeah, he's gonna follow me! Alright, come with me!
Come with me. Come with me.
Oh. I'm gonna be alone forever, aren't I? Ah, who cares? I got gold bars in my inventory. I'm good. Those can comfort me to sleep. Cold, hard metal that's actually relatively soft and has a low melting point. Alright, haven't been that way. Let's go that way. Yeah, that's where those goblins were hanging out, right? Yes. I hear wind. Where there's wind, there's a tunnel. Yeah. You can keep your ribs. Double damage! Exclamation mark, exclamation mark, exclamation mark, exclamation mark. Okay, well, before I continue that way.
Me caught big fish. My fish bigger.
That's it. End of the argument.
What are you doing here?
We water people live here because can go fishing. Fishes.
My fish bigger.
We hating earth people.
Why?
Because them eat rats. That not good.
Fish good.
If you is kill them, we is give you big magic thing.
Big fish magic.
Magic thing is belong to great wizard before.
Great fish wizard.
I see.
Yeah, when the other one said water people, I thought they meant like water elementals or something. Or a fish monster. They're just talking about different tribes of goblins. Alright, they both want me to kill each other, and they're both promising me some magical thing. Right. Oh, look at that. Roasting a fish on the stick. It's a cool little detail.
Me hungry.
Did one of those fishes disappear? Ow.
Thief! Here is human!
No, I'm not a thief! Okay. I thought they'd probably think that. I wanted to try it anyway, though. Because I really want to know if you can fish. I tried to fish before and it just didn't seem to work, but... You know, if I used a fishing rod right next to a dude using a fishing rod and it didn't work, then I'd pretty much know for sure that it definitely did not work. How did he even see me anyway? I was behind him. Maybe I can take it now?
Thief!
Nope! He noticed.
We haters, clan! Destroy them!
Earth people bad!
The best reasoned argument I have ever heard.
Nasty earth! We hate!
Alright, I think I see an anarchist.
Get out! Whoa. You is scaring. If you not get out of water, we can't catch fishes.
Alright, hold on. Calm your fishing rod. I just want the anarchist rock, okay?
Stupid human! Scare fishes!
Alright, it seems like that's all that's in there. Let's hope he's not too angry at me. No, it's fine. Okay, so do I actually want to kill either of the clans? Can't I just convince them that they're, you know, they're the same people, like, it's alright, calm down. Stop hating. Is there a switch around here or something? I hear that wind. It could just be a wind coming from the other chamber that's behind here. Like, if you look on the map, you know, it could be coming from there. Perhaps it's nothing secret. Whoa. The hell is that thing? Humans! Hi. It's a human mining camp?
I preferred it as it was before.
Hello, A-Man.
Welcome, stranger. My name is Mopek. I buy and sell all sorts of things. Pick up what takes your fancy. If you want to sell me something, put the object in my coffers, and I will make you an offer.
That sounds wonderful, Mopek. Let me see what you have on offer.
My brother may be able to help you. I'm far too busy.
Busy? Yes, yes, of course. What did you just swallow? Wasn't a cyanide capsule, was it? Whoa. Slayer Blade, 11 damage. Adds 3 to my armor. Critical plus 10, stealth minus 10, that doesn't matter. 14 strength. 60 close combat. Okay, I'm not gonna be able to use that for a long time. Could use some torches. Darker Ring of Magic Resistance. Well, I already have that exact ring, I believe. 2020? Yeah, 2020. Jesus! These people are so fucking loud! It's like complete silence. Complete silence. Complete silence.
Anyway...
Hello! Oh man, these are way too expensive. There's no way I'm paying like 800. For a freaking one-time use spell. Some runes here. And a piece of wood. And a wooden stake. I really suspect these stakes are used for vampires or something like that. Maybe, I mean, I don't even know vampires exist. Maybe they do, maybe they don't. I'm really suspecting they do, though. Maybe it's just used for the undead. Like, maybe the undead don't stay dead. I could actually get in there, but I'd probably be stuck in there. I'm gonna try that in a minute, but I'm gonna save it before I do that. Okay, well, do I have any garbage to sell? Can I actually sell all of my keys or just the key ring? If you could sell your keys, oh my god. That'd be very, very bad, let's just say. Alright, well, let's buy a couple torches. They're very cheap and I'm running a bit low. Everything else can stay, it's fine.
Who does he think he is?
It's an ominous emblem. It's not really an emblem. I don't know what you call that. Hello, fine gentleman. Would it be stealing to steal his tools? Hello, A-Man.
Welcome, traveler. You'd be better off talking to my brother here.
Your brother just told me to talk to you because he's too busy swallowing something.
I don't have time to talk to you. Speak to my brother.
I feel like I'm in some bureaucratic nightmare. It's probably stealing to open the chest.
Locked.
Unless I lockpicked it. And then it's not stealing, right? It's totally not stealing if you have to work for it.
Not really a very successful attempt.
Okay, so that means there is a chance. It's just a percentage chance.
There you go.
Okay. He's not looking. Quickly! 500 coins. Regeneration ring. Oh, yes, it worked! I just took 500 coins and a regeneration ring to replace the one that for some reason completely disappeared. It must have broken. Because it does have a durability. But what makes it break? Just taking damage in general? I mean, it's kind of weird because rings don't really get hit. Our armor does. You know, weapons do. But why would a ring get hit? So why would it have durability? I don't know, it's weird. Yeah, I mean, this spellcasting ring doesn't have durability. I guess the regeneration rings are just short-lived. In fact, maybe they just... the durability goes away even when you're not getting hurt. So maybe they only work for a limited time? I'm gonna have to check it in a bit.
Anyway...
Alright, he's not looking. I just totally robbed him blind. Oh, what is this? Some sordid affairs. Look the other way. There you go. Ooh, map updated. Here's the map showing how to reach the Snake Woman's hideout. I found a huge number of different objects there that we will be able to sell further at a good price. Ooh! Where would that be on my map? Secret pathway to the Snake Woman, that's back on path number 4. And, on path number 4, where I'm supposed to try to stop Shawnee from getting sacrificially sacrificed, I'm supposed to meet at the Serpent's Pillar, and I would bet the Serpent's Pillar is probably where the Snake Woman lives. It's a pretty safe bet. Okay, now let's try to get stuck inside of the pig pen. Unless there's an invisible wall? I think there might be. Nope. Hi. Any secrets in here? It's gotta be something good. Actually, you're probably not... probably not meant to be here, so there probably actually isn't anything. Nope. Not a thing. And I think someone is calling me, so I'll be right back. Well, I didn't recognize the number, and they left a voicemail that was like 3 seconds of them fumbling with their phone. So I think I'm gonna die in 7 days or something like that. Let's see if I can get out of here. Gonna have to go back the way I came. Oh, look at that! See, now that is smart level design. Give players a way to get out if they get themselves in. Geronimo! Hi.
My brother may be able to help you.
No, he's not.
I'm far too busy.
Your brother's just as much of a prick as you. Actually, no, you're okay. You're okay. I mean, you lied to me about being busy, but aside from that, you're actually pretty polite. Let's check my ring. Okay, yeah, so the durability has not just been going down. I wonder if that refers to how many points of damage it heals. 1 point of damage for each durability point? That'd get burned out so fast, though, because right now I only have... yeah, I've only got 66 hit points, there's no way. Okay, where was I going? Oh yeah, down here. I still haven't decided what I want to do with the goblins, if anything. I kind of don't want to get involved. I mean, they haven't attacked me. Not those particular goblins. You know, if those air ducts are supplying air from the outside world, then it's got to be really, really cold air. Oh shit, that's a lower level. Ooh, what's even deeper? I don't want to go too deep. Oh my god. I'm already scared. I don't like this place. Oh god, I'm on the 6th level. I don't like this place. I don't like this place. Oh, it's a chicken. What's down here? Spiders? Okay. It's not too bad. Hi.
What does this do?
This doesn't work for some reason.
Can I break this? I really probably shouldn't be down here. What's that? Oh, hi. Okay, you can't get me. You can't get me. I think. Whoa. Hello. Leather helmet of great stealth? Could sell that. It's unidentified. I don't even have the skill to identify it. I wonder if I could even take that thing on. I don't know. First, though, I want to know what this is. I think that's a ring. A gold ring. Okay, so it's just for selling. If only I could aim down more, I could hit it with my magic missiles. What? That did not go the direction I aimed. Alright, I'm gonna try it. Take out your sword! Oh. Okay. Where'd you go? Oh fuck, spider's coming. Chicken, you're gonna get caught in the crossfire, okay? You gotta move. Alright, get out of here, you cock. Oh, sweet. Where'd the damn ratmen go? They have some really impressive skills in invisibility and movement. Very fast. Very agile. I really shouldn't be down here. I think this is way too high level of a place for me. But I really want to keep looking for treasures such as this. There's a noise coming from back there. Sounds like a machine. Okay, I'm gonna leave. Is this thing light up? Okay, where have I not been? Could go up to the next floor, look for the serpent's special place. There's a couple pathways. It's hard to tell, though, if there's actually something there that's blocking you from continuing, or if you just haven't explored it. Because I know at least one of these ways is simply blocked. I still don't know what I want to do about the goblins. You know, I'm just gonna go back and talk to the other goblins and... let's see if we can work something out. Maybe we can. If I can remember where they are. Actually, is this just the way back? That is the way back. Or is it? Actually, I don't know if that's the way back. That might be a way back. Regardless, I can just use the portal to get back. I think they're this way. Hello? No, this is where I came from. Shit. Okay, so that just goes up. That goes up. So the only areas here that look like they might lead somewhere that I haven't been are here and here. I'm pretty sure they don't go anywhere, though. That really looks like a doorway. Looking for a lever. Something to pull, something to push. I don't see one. It's possible it's only activated from the other side. Everything's just a varying form of brown. So. It's a little bit hard to tell. I guess if I had a high intuition, I might be able to see a button or something like that, because I think it highlights them or something. Oh well. Alright, here's the gang. Let's see if they have any words to say. Okay. I guess they prefer the rats over my beautiful apple pie. I'll take it back, thank you.
Water people,
you is kill all water people yet?
No.
You is kill all water people yet?
No. 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 No.
Are you a good person?
No.
Do you bathe regularly?
No.
Antok should have been the king.
Well, you know, I don't really want to murder them. Because, let's be honest, that's exactly what it would be. But I'm kind of curious what'll happen. I'd be being a... I'd be a complete prick to do it, though. I really don't want to murder them. They didn't do anything. They're just minding their own business eating rats. Which is disgusting, but not deserving of murder. Garlic. Here, let me cook these ribs for you. You're welcome. Yeah, I'm not gonna murder them. They're alright. Okay, let's go up. So let's see, I came... Shit, where did I come from? I actually don't want to go up the way I came, because if I go up a different way, I might be able to get myself to an area on the fourth level that I couldn't access when I was there before. Yeah, I believe this is the way that I did not come from, up here. So let's go check it out. How many torches do I have left? Two. This one doesn't work either. Oh no, this is this thing. Right, which is probably still not gonna work.
That's not possible.
Nope. It's possible killing the goblins may allow me entrance into there. Maybe. You know, maybe they have a key or something like that. But for now, let's not do that. Yeah, I remember messing with this, but I'm pretty sure this one was also impossible. Right?
I can't do that.
Yeah, they didn't use up a durability, right?
That's not possible.
Nope. It's weird, I was stuck.
It's impossible.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure the point of the lever is simply to get it out of the way. I mean, aside from that, it seems like there was no way to get in there, but then again, the X is here. It does say that's where the secret pathway is. Let's go check it out. I mean, I know there's this secret pathway. This one didn't work either, though, did it? And I don't have the keys to any of this stuff, do I? No.
I can't do that.
No? I mean, how do I even get over there? Pretty sure if I go back this way, I'm just gonna transition to the upper floor. Oh! Well, here's a whole area I never found. Hi. Well, shit. Okay, I guess I am gonna find the meeting place, so let's read that note once again. Precious offering, which is probably Shawnee. It's a ritual. They're gonna be at the Serpent's Pillar on the 4th level at 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. There's no sense of time, so I don't think that matters. From there, I will lead you to the secret chamber, where we will call up the 5,000 Sons of the Beast. So I'm assuming they're already going to be in there, which means I'm probably going to have to find the Serpent's Pillar and then find the secret chamber from there. God damn you. Oh shit, that's the torch. I didn't want to cue up the torch. Got the ignite out of my rotation. Those things just disappear. Like, it seems like they don't even stick around long enough to kill them. Also, what does this symbol mean next to my sword? It's a little symbol, but I don't know what it means. It's a pointless hole if I've ever seen one. I can't even fit inside of it. Ooh, another teleportal. I was gonna queue it up again. Oh my. Whoa. There's a trail of coins on the ground in a chest. That might be the start of Oliver's treasure hunt. Ooh. Alright, let's activate this portal. Let's get unstuck. Are you fucking kidding me? Okay, thank you. I've gotten stuck before, by the way. Off camera. I got stuck once inside of a curtain, of all things. Yeah, that was a fun time. Okay, let's see if I can remember how to do this. Top down. Then... Okay, I think I know it. No, that's not it. Yep, and then... There we go. Oh, I see how it works. The more you unlock... Yeah, the more you unlock, the more portals you have to go through. I was wondering, yeah, how you're gonna... Oh, for fuck's sake! I was wondering how you're gonna select where you wanted to go. So that means the number of portals you can activate is equal to the number of sides this thing has, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And how many levels are there? There are 8. Okay, so there's one per level. Gotcha. Yeah, let's just go down here. Time to go down, if you know what I mean.
Here comes human.
I heard that. I'm not gonna open that chest, it's rather suspicious.
You not move! Bad human!
Okay.
Me eat your heart!
I'm not moving. Now I am.
Where is human?
Hi? Hello? Hello?
You is fighting like curl you head off.
I don't know where the hell they are. They keep yelling at me, I'm just gonna keep exploring. They sound so close. Hold on. Can I get up here?
Get
no.
You is fight like girl goblin.
All right. Well, let's go ahead and open the chest and hope nothing explodes. Whoa. Oh, here we go. Now that I opened it, they actually come out.
Me cut you head off.
I think I'm gonna cut your head off, sir.
Stay here.
And so I have. So, were they just like invisible until I opened the chest? That was weird. Yeah, I don't think that's related to the treasure hunt. I think that's a very silly trap. They just put some gold out in the hope that some fool would try to open it. I think they were hoping that whatever fool would try to open it would have less gear than me. Yeah, there's nothing inside of it. Nonetheless, I can try putting an emerald in it. Yeah, that's not Oliver's chest. You know, it's really not worth picking up this coin. I think I'm just gonna leave it there as a landmark, so I kind of know where this place is if I see it again. Because that's a very memorable thing. A trail of gold on the ground. It's not something you see every day. Come on, Amshigar.
Not really a very successful attempt.
Come on, Amshigar.
There you go.
There you go. Good job, Ami. Oh my god. Yeah, look at my regeneration ring. It's already 29 out of 50. Alright, I'm gonna take this thing off, and I'm just gonna save it for like a hard boss fight or something. Looks like an alchemy brewing place. Looks like an abandoned laboratory. Shit, what did I catch on fire? It's a torch. Put it out! The fucking fire! Gonna burn the book. What is this? It's a candle. Oh, can light candles on fire too. Neat, I suppose that's an old style flare. Dagger? Yeah, whatever. I'll take it. The Power of Chickens by Lord Anut. The Farmer of Laiklau. Let's open up this ponderous tomb. Tome. I have devoted my whole life to the study of this amazing animal, the chicken. It is hard to believe that horrible wizards shamelessly use these marvelous creatures so often to perform their evil rituals, sacrificing them for their magic. I am convinced that chickens are endowed with a great deal of intuition and humor. The chicken race is made up of 57 different species, each one more amazing than the next, and each with its own culture and way of living. I spent 8 years, day and night, in contact with chickens to try and understand them. I even learned to walk like them to show my respect for them. After a great deal of concentration, I succeeded in transforming myself into a chicken. You could say, then, that I am kind of a were-chicken, turning into a chicken when the moon is favorable. This new skill, understandably, had a wonderful effect on my studies. I was able to live with chickens, eat with them, feel what they feel, dance with them, and even talk to them. Their language is, in fact, very complex. I will give you a few examples of translation from chicken to human. Bok means hello. Brok means what are you doing? Bok bok indicates that one is about to do what one is about to do is forbidden. And bok shows a marked interest in something. I could go into more detail with my translations to show you all the nuances of the chicken's clucking, but I think that a simple example should be enough for the intelligence of a normal human being. What I found out about the intelligence of chickens is just how pronounced their sense of altruism is. In a chicken community, the dominant male goes out into nearby areas to look for food, if none is to be found. As soon as he has found some, he puts a single foot on it and lets rip with a great brok, which calls the rest of the community to come and feed. He observes them with a loving eye, and only eats once all others have had their fill. As part of my experimentation, I have been trying to lay an egg for years now, as yet without success. A recent study suggested to me that perhaps this was due to my being male, but I cannot subscribe to such a simplistic explanation. This is why I live in hope to this day. That is the single best piece of writing I have ever read in an RPG. Bravo, writers. Bravo. I don't mean that sarcastically, by the way. Seriously, that was fucking great.
Locked.
I wonder if I'll ever encounter this were-chicken.
It's impossible.
Only because you suck. Actually, no, I don't know if that's true. Yeah, I'm still not entirely sure how it works. I don't know if it's the case that if you're low level and you encounter a high level lock, if that just means you have a very, very, very small chance, or if that can make it literally impossible to pick. I don't know. So I'm not sure if it's simply a... if the lockpicking skill is simply a modifier on your chance, modifying a chance that you already have, or if it's a pass or fail sort of thing.
Locked. That's not possible.
There's a key. Yeah, I can brew up some potions if I want to. Which I really don't. Actually, you know what? If you had to make some potions really quickly, there's actually a pretty good place to do it, because it's actually right next to the portal. Although, getting back up to the portal might be a little bit difficult, because I don't even know how to get there. Unless this leads to it? This actually might lead back up.
There you go.
Hello, more duels. And a piece of paper. With writing on it, too. Cool. I really wish these had more distinctive names. Dear Oliver. Oh, hello! I'm looking for an Oliver. I am sorry, but I'm unable to solve the fourth riddle. Do you think you might be able to give me a clue? Okay, well, Mike apparently perished here. Is this suggesting that Oliver is in the vicinity? Perhaps maybe Oliver lived here? Perhaps that's why I can't open the chests. Hold on. I just try to press the L key to use my torch, because I'm used to Stalker. And it's T for torch, not L for light. Okay, let's try the emerald. Oh god, if this is gonna work, I'm gonna be so happy. Inside. I'm guessing that's the next clue. It's gotta be the next clue. Some potions, too. Light potion and a poisonous potion. What does it say? That's not it. Is this it? That's not it. God damn it, where did it go? No. No. Ah, it's here. Replace the emerald's slot. Aha! I see we have a new player. Welcome, stranger. Here is the first clue. The key to the treasure. Wait. The key to the treasure. For the next clue, go to the troll's mines and find the note beneath the stones. What? I mean, for the next clue I get that, but the first clue is the key to the treasure. What does that mean? I'm not sure, but this is incredibly cool. See, this is what I really, really like in an RPG. Is when you find something like this and it feels special. Because you know what would have made this feel not very special? Is if you're guaranteed to have a quest and it tells you where to go to find Oliver's chest, then it wouldn't feel very special, right? Because everybody does it. Everybody, maybe not necessarily everybody completes the quest, but at least everybody kind of starts it. And finding the treasure chest is nothing. But in this case, the only reason I know about Oliver's chest, and the only reason I've been looking out for it, is because I saw a piece of writing back within like the very first hour, or actually a little bit after, slightly after an hour of playing the game. So that was like 4 hours ago at this point. Like, 4 hours ago, near the beginning of the game, I saw that note saying to place an emerald in Oliver's chest. And so I had that in my mind. Look for a chest and look for an emerald. And then I fought an incredibly strong spider, went into its lair, and found an emerald. Which is why I've been keeping the emerald instead of selling it this entire time. Hoping to finally find Oliver's chest. Then I come to this location that I in no way had to come to. I could have easily missed this if I hadn't explored. Found a note that mentioned Oliver. which got me thinking, hey, maybe all, you know, Oliver is around here, or maybe this is Oliver's place. And then I made the connection to, oh, wait, here's chests that I can't open, so maybe the emerald opens them. And then it did. Like, that is how you make something special. You make it something that you have to actually work for. And pay attention to find. And of course, when you do that, and I figure a lot of the reason that a lot of people that make RPGs don't do stuff like that is because there's naturally going to be stuff that people miss. Like, undoubtedly, there's stuff that I've missed that means there's other special things that I just won't discover. Because I just haven't noticed it. Haven't made the connections. But even though you do miss some stuff, the stuff that you do find, like Oliver's freaking chest, become incredibly special. Like, that is really, really cool. Alright, so there is another chest.
Locked.
Wouldn't it be funny if the end of the treasure chest is actually just to come all the way back to Oliver's place and just open the other chest? I mean, it does say the first clue is the key to the treasure. The key to the treasure chest was an emerald. Is that what it refers to? You know what, maybe I just have no idea how a freaking clue hunt works. Maybe I just need to... I just need to collect all the clues, don't I? Yeah, I just need to get all the clues. So I think the key to the treasure is irrelevant at the moment. I just need to go find the next clue. That's probably it.
Locked.
I do wonder if another emerald would open this one, though. Seems unlikely, but... Perhaps a chunk of gold? No. Troll's amulet? Piece of cheese? Okay, forget it. Magic missiles?
You cannot break it just like that.
Yeah, this game is incredibly cool. Really, really cool. Okay, well, I think I'm gonna end this episode here. I am more invigorated than ever to keep playing this game. You know, a little while ago, I was thinking I remembered why I stopped playing, and that's because I kept getting lost. And, I mean, that's kind of true, that did keep happening. But now I'm wondering why I ever stopped playing. It's really, really good so far. Yeah, hopefully you can keep it up. Alright, so I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I will be back soon where I will continue exploring level number 4, try to find the secret pathway to the Snake Woman, see if I can find Shawnee and save her from the evil ritual. And yeah, have some more fun, maybe do Oliver's treasure hunt a little bit, find the next clue. So, hope you've enjoyed, and I'll be back soon.